Hi Harsh, good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm fine. What about you?
I am also fine. Actually, I have no other answer to say. This is an introductory part and we always have to say we are fine. But we know that we are not fine many a times, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. That's the conviction.
Right. So today's topic, do you know?
Yeah, today's topic is importance of medication.
Importance of medication. So before we start, please introduce yourself to little, because here you're new to me. So I'd like to know a little bit about you. Do not say in detail, just your academic career and what you want to be in your life. That's all.
Yes, ma'am. So currently I'm pursuing my post-graduation in history. And alongside, I'm preparing for civil services examination and other government examinations.
Okay, so you're preparing UPSC, civil service exam, UPSC for being an IAS officer?
Yes, ma'am, UPSC or state commission exams, that's what I'm preparing. That's what my main focus is right now.
Okay, so your colleges are running right now or everything is being closed?
Right now, I've been promoted to the second year of my graduation. Yes, ma'am. So right now, there's still a gap. There's a vacation. And after that, the college will decide whether to conduct classes online or offline.
Okay. Even when the first wave started of this corona, I was in my post-graduation final year. And then there was an issue in Maharashtra. I am from Maharashtra. So there was an issue going on that whether to conduct examination or not. Then Maharashtra government suddenly cancelled the exam. I started working. After that, I got job. And after I started working, after 2 months, it was announced that exams are going to be conducted. And then I had to take a leave and start preparing again. And then in the first wave, we had our exam conducted through online mode. But this year, students were fortunate or unfortunate, I do not know, but everyone is promoted. That's good. Is that good for you or not?
Yes, ma'am, because I was personally for me, I was preparing for the services. I was preparing for the other examinations and I was also doing some freelance work when I was before. So yes, for me, I didn't have the time to prepare for my academic studies of my post-graduation. So I think it's a good news for me. So yeah, that we are promoted to the next level. So that was the ease of burden for me.
Right. Good. I noticed you are very good at speaking, but the only mistake you do is you go very fast. Take it at a slow pace. Okay. The more slower you are, the more clear you sound. Okay, the way I am talking, right? The more slow you talk, the more better you sound and the more fluency you gain because you get more time to think about it. No, for example, if I'm saying so slow and I have time to think upon the next sentence. Okay, I meanwhile keep thinking also that what do I say next? Okay, and when we speak faster, what happens is we are so fast and we get nervous. We speak everything at sudden and suddenly there is a sound of, what happened? Like this. Does that happen with you?
Yes. Yeah.
So that's the only concern I find in your conversation in just 2 minutes itself. That's the only thing you need to improve with, lest everything is fine. All right. So as I heard your introduction, I heard that you are doing post-graduation. That's really nice. Keep continuing and congratulations. You are promoted to the next level. As a part of our meditation process, in this, I am going to ask you some general questions. We are nobody scientifically proven people to judge on meditation or give scientific predicaments about it. But here we are going to simply talk why is it important and why do people need to practice it. Okay, so are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
This conversation is going to be really short because it's an introduction part for us today. I am introducing you to my channel. You are new to me completely. We would continue forward. We would continue forward in our next class. Let my people also know that there is a boy called Harsh on my channel who's coming up to join me and coming live to face the camera here. And I like your smile, okay? You look good while smiling.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Just a simple question. When you said that you are fine, when I asked you that, are you fine, Harsh? You said, yes, I'm fine, right? If there was somebody, other person, not me, somebody close to you, your answer would have been something different, isn't it?
Yes, it would have been different. But as I said that, it's in the convention. People say that they are fine when actually something else is going on in their mind. So And yes, if somebody else had called me, if I was having conversation with one of my friends or family members, I would have said something different. I would have stated what's really going on in my mind. So yes, the answer would have been a little different when it was someone else. So that's what I feel.
Okay, so it differs from person to person. In fact, it varies from person to person we meet. Okay, so why does this happen? You know, what is responsible for this answer in your body? What is responsible?
Yeah, like I said, that is the convention. It's conventional answer. So it's to save time that people say that they are doing fine. And when they are actually having some or little problems. So yeah, it's like it's the normal way to talk with people. I think it's an official statement people
give. Statement, yes. It has become an introduction part to start a conversation with, isn't it? And we do not feel like this girl doesn't need to know so much about me. Why would I say her that? So I'm fine. Thank you. And what about you? I'll say the same sentence. I'm fine too. But our brain comes to know that this person is a stranger. He doesn't need to know. Okay. When there's somebody near to us and coming in front of us, we'll say this person is near to us. We need to say him the truth. Okay. And yes, we might feel better after we interact with that person, isn't it? So I'm just trying to say here is when our brain is so sophisticated, it has capability to think so much. Still, yes, we stay under depression. Still, we are told to meditate every day. Isn't it amazing? Yes, it's something like other people are unable to do all this. There's a network error, I guess, from your side somewhere, little bit.
I don't think so, ma'am.
It's okay. Everything is fine.
Okay, then.
Let me know if your phone starts heating, all right? I'll end the conversation here. And then after you charge your phone, we'll continue it on the next session. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so let me know. So I was asking you is if at all you feel like your brain is so sophisticated, it has the capability to answer everything. Still, we need the meditation part. Why is it so? Why is it meditation so important for us?
Yeah, because human mind, there's so many things. There are millions of things that a human mind can accommodate to think. And to process all of that thing, we need to keep everything together. We need to focus on one thing because there are certain things that we have to do. We have to be concerned now. That is in our priority list. There are so many things that is in our priority list. So, but due to so many other thoughts as well, we cannot focus in that particular thing. So to keep that focus on that particular thing, that thing that is our priority. So we need to keep our mind together. We need to keep our mind focused for that thing. So that's why it is recommended to people meditate. On regular basis.
So in short, you're trying to say is, in short, you could have concluded that we need to be present at the moment and focus on a particular instance we are doing. Okay, rather than getting distracted to other things. And meditation is something which brings focus to our self, right? Is it so?
Yes, ma'am. Also, it brings the peace of mind. And
yes, ma'am. And it helps the mental stability. It helps us to be stable mentally, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So I feel this introduction was enough for both of us. We'll start from our next session. I could understand what all pros and cons you have in your English speaking. I've judged it all and we'll start improving it from the next coming sessions. Okay, so you like the introduction here? Do you have any feedbacks? Yes,
yeah, I think it's a really good introduction and thanks for telling me the mistakes that I was making during my speech. So it was in all, it was a really good session.
Okay, so instead of telling, you could have used deciphering. Okay, that's a good word. Decipher.
Okay.
Or decipher. Uncovering it. Okay. Telling is actually become very basic for all of us. Even I keep trying learning some vocabulary, advanced vocabulary, which would eradicate the simple words from my life. Okay. So you also keep trying the same. Yeah. So I'll see you in the next class, Harsh. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Bye bye. Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am. Good night.